Hey there. So today I'm going to be giving a full overview slash review of the new DLC map pack that Gameloft made for the game Modern Combat 2, Black Pegasus. I'm not going to be going over any of the stuff in the update other than just these maps. They cost $2. It's just downloadable through the game, so I'm guessing jailbreakers can't totally get it. But let's go ahead and hop onto this and get into it. So let's see. So I'm going to be going from worst to best maps, just in my opinion. I'm sure everybody else may think different, but this is just me. So this is Bunker. You cannot go downstairs. Well, not like down in here, but so let's see. There is a large room up in here, and then I know that there is a hallway going down through here. It's kind of tough to explain, but I'm just going to walk it out for you as I sort of talk about this. So overall, Gameloft did an amazing job with these map packs. See, so then it comes down here, and then we just go through here as there are small rooms on the side. Sort of encouraging camping, but I haven't seen that on this map yet. Normally, everybody is running around in multiplayer trying to find people. So once you go through here, you loop up to here into the bigger rooms. But these maps have quite a lot of detail. Back to the center right there, so it's just a loop. So now we have these little side rooms. If you look on the maps, you can tell that they are a whole lot better than the first ones, just having to do with detail. Maybe not for gameplay, I haven't played enough online to really experience that, but just from what I can tell. Let's see. So as you can see, it's quite the large map, and all three of these new maps are actually quite large, so I kind of think that could lead to slower gameplay, but I think I basically have covered that. So it's just a long hallway along there, sort of just this inner room, then just outer stuff all the way around. So I think everybody can get that from there. That map, it's not, I don't consider it the best, but it is, all these maps are nice for sniping, I'll tell you that. Now, oh, there goes my phone, hang on. And we're back. So, this one is called Shantytown, and this, I would say it would be my favorite. I think this is going to be a lot of people's favorites for the map pack, except just for me, the next one is my favorite. But this, out of detail, compared to a normal console map, it is quite amazing. Like, especially, and the lighting is also really nice in certain places. Like, here, let's see, I'll go over here. Okay, well, maybe I shouldn't make too much on that, but, I mean, it's quite fancy, but here is the center of the map, and you can go down on either side. So basically this is a big rectangle. You have this side, and then you have this side. Then you have these two upper areas. So let's go ahead and I'll show you the downstairs. So it goes off to two sides. It's almost identical around. They sort of both just lead to the opposite side. And on each side, there are also stairs that just lead back up. So, I'll show you that. As you can see here, going back up. And so then you can see the center is just right here again. So let me just walk over to this side, but let me just talk about this map a little bit with the gameplay for multiplayer. It is actually quite fun. It's long range and short range at the same time. Like, look at this. For the first time, they're actually giving, you know, vantage points and stuff like that. So you can actually look down on players and, you know, stuff like that. It's just sort of giving it more variety. So, of course, that goes down onto this side, under. And then the other side is almost identical to that, but let's see. Yeah, I just kind of like the lighting of the sun there. It's quite nice. Let's see. So of course you can see then I'm pretty sure that this right here, crosses not over. Yes, it actually does, right here, you can see. Yes, so it's just a big rectangle. You're gonna need to get used to the maps after a while, just like you have to do for things like, well, I don't know. The maps that they have before, are not very complicated. Now this is the most easy to understand when it comes to finding your way around. This is just an amazing map, I'll say that. Extremely nice for sniping. So, and quite good for, I would say that this is going to be good for spawn trapping and capture the flag as long as you don't push up the spawn too much. So, let's see. Right here you just have this little building, I don't want to go too much. This is, it's just a complete two-sided map with some, what do they call it, trenches in the middle. So, that's all it is here. So let's go ahead out onto the actual battlefield. What I really love about this map is that there are obstacles everywhere. You can hide practically anywhere, and it's actually gonna probably encourage camping, but as long as the players aren't that bad or anything, but from what I've played on it, it is some really nice gameplay. So you have this left route here, and it has this line of trenches going all the way down the middle. Then as you can see, there's one more through here. So back there, there's a tunnel there. So basically, there's two ways leading from each side. So now you come back out on this side, you can see that it is almost identical, just doesn't have the building. But you've got these things back here, which I personally think would actually be kind of fun to get a team together and just sort of hide back here the whole game. But so as you can see, two-sided, no way to get lost in here. You will catch onto this map very, very easily, and that's why I like it. See, it's quite long range, quite long range, and nice for assault rifles if you're going to be rushing. But that is what we've got for these things today. I'm talking about the final things about, I'm gonna try and go into multiplayer. But overall, I definitely recommend getting the map pack for only $2. If you're worrying about the price, you probably shouldn't, because this is great. Ew, okay. That's just one little glitch right here that, I don't know, it keeps on making me restore the purchases. I'm not even gonna type my password. So there you go. That is all we have for today, and I hope this helped you with the map packs, maybe even just if you want to understand it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time with gameplay of this and not just a review. Later, kids.